Hey, I'm Joe Drake. I'm the president, current president of UMass chapter of Backcountry Hunters and Anglers, a TU member and a PhD student down at UMass. And today I'm gonna show you how to tie a Kimbari style fly. It's a kind of a Japanese variant of a soft hackle that's often used with Tenkara style rods, but I find it is a really good fly that you can use with just any old rod, especially in small streams when the fish are pretty hungry. So we're going to start with a size 12 barbless hook. Any old barbless hook or barbed hook if you want to do that, but I use this fulling mill style, or if you want to be more traditional, you can spend some extra bucks and get this Gamatsu style hook. And the thread we're going to be using today is this 6-aught. And I like using either a pure red body or a tan or olive or gray body with a bright orange tag here by the bend of the hook. So you're just gonna start your hook in, the thread into the hook, and then just wind it down. Make sure you're getting pretty tight in there. And I like when I'm using just a full red thread body to get all the way down into that bend and come back. Make sure no gaps left in there. All the way back up to the eye of the hook. And the reason I don't mind to crowd the eye right now is because we're not going to come back here after we leave. So I'm using some hen pheasant feathers, so I've stripped off all the fluff, and so we're just going to do one of these, pull all those back. Some people like to strip off one side to make it a bit cleaner. I like the extra hackle in there, it makes it seem buggier, especially with it being folded forward like you get with the Kimbari style fly. Something I would note that's really important is when you're laying it in, make sure you have that curve of that feather going up when you lay it in before you tie it in. So you're gonna get in there, hold it in place, wrap it in a couple times. I like to wrap it in and then make sure it's extra secure. Fold that little puff back over top. Then make sure you take this, move it forward, move it back behind the feather. And then what I like to do is push all these fibers forward as you wrap the hackle around, and keep moving the hackle behind itself as you wrap. Keep pushing those fibers forward as they fold over each other, and you'll notice that it gets nice, fishy looking as all these fibers lay across on top of each other. Then, when you get to a good point, maybe three or four wraps, you have the hackle sitting there. You just lock it in with a couple wraps of your thread. And you just take that out of there. Clean up any loose bits, shears. Push everything forward, sure you get a couple final wraps in there to lock it in place. Now, at this point, I like to cover those little remaining bits down in the back, and then bring it forward. Take a piece of peacock earl. Take off the hard back end and lay it in. Lock it in with a couple wraps. And bring it back near the end and wrap the hurl forward. This allows you to bring the thread back over the hurl, which is really delicate. So it strengthens the hurl and increases the longevity of the fly and adds a nice little ribbing to it as well. And just knock that off. Locked in place. With a couple panda whip finishes. Make sure it's nice and tight. Pull that off. And you have a finished Kimbari style wet fly. And if you really were running out of other stuff in your kit, if you're just going out minimalistic and you just have a couple of these and the fish are on the rise, you can gunk this up with some floatant and dap it across the surface, and it works pretty well. And you can also do a kind of a swing it in the current, and then kind of when you're swinging it, kind of give it a little a pulse, and so these will kind of jellyfish out. And it looks super buggy, and it works really well for me, like I said, especially for those hungry little brook trout.